Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. How are you? Okay, everybody okay? All right. Good. Today I will give you one group homework. And then we are going to do the exponent derivative. And integration both, because that is one of the things I still have not covered yet, and we need to do that. So let's look at the did I give you 12.3, I'm sorry. No, 11.3. Did I give you the homework question on the consumer surplus? Producer surplus. Dah bagi ke belum? 13.4. Example, 13.2, 13.4. Saya tak bagi lagi. I'll give you some questions on that topic: consumer surplus, producer surplus. They give you a question on 13.3. I don't know. 13.3. Did I give you questions on 13.3? 13.3 on the area between functions. So that, 13.3 saya dah bagi. 13.2, 13.4. Okay, so finish. So everything done. Now, what I want to do. After at the end of the class, I will give you the group homework. Now we are going to do the derivative of E exponent function, and then we are going to look at integration, integral, derivative or integral of E, the exponent function. E means exponent. This will be chapter number berapa? Number 3. Okay, number 3. Chapter number, oh yeah, number 3. 12. Chapter number berapa? The derivative. That is on the integral. Derivative there is chapter. We have to go back. Buka balik kitab yang lama. Derivative. Dia punya apa nama? The chapter number for the exponent and the log function. That is the derivative that we want to do. Chapter number 11. Okay, 11. Chapter number 11, 10, 12. We go to chapter number 11.2. Can we start with 11.2 on the exponent function? Okay. Now, what is exponent function? Exponent function is something like this. You have a function, you know, equal to some constant multiplied by e. Okay, we are going to look at the e function. Okay, basic exponent function, y equal to e to the power of x. Of course, sometimes, you know, you can have a constant multiplied by e to some power of x. And the graph, the basic graph, look something like this. Okay.
Say that share screen.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. Share screen. Sorry, dengar, eh? Oh, share screen. Okay. All right, so we have the curve, the E function. Okay, the curve will look like this. You can refer to the book, chapter 11.1. You see the line, okay? The line will start from a very low value of x and y. And then as y increases, the value of y or the value of the function increases faster. Okay, you see here the line becomes steeper. So you can see here from the second diagram by looking at the derivative at the slope at each point, at different points. So here you see the slope, flat, you know, very small slope, derivative, value of derivative is small. And then the slope keep on increasing. So when the slope keep on increasing as x increases, that means the curve will increase faster. Right? The curve will increase very fast. So that is exponent function. It looks like that. Okay. So if you look at the value, the basic function y equal to ex, you see here y increases faster. Faster and faster as x increases. And we can also see here, as x increases, the y prime also becomes bigger. Okay, become larger or bigger. Y prime or the slope. Okay, the slope, the different points become bigger. So therefore, y, that's why you y become steeper and steeper. Okay, so you look at the graph, you see the line look like in figure 11.6. Okay, so figure 11.6. Which I can show you. So that is E function, okay? All right, now, what you are interested in doing is taking the derivative of this kind of function. So the general rule, okay? The general rule of the derivative is this. If Y is a function of E, a function of e to the power of u, where u is some terms in x, then what is the derivative? Dy dx or y prime is equal to e to the power of u multiplied by u prime or du dx. So that is the derivative. Now all the rules of derivative apply. So we don't need any other rules. So for the derivative, all right, all rules apply. So in other words, the power rule, the constant rule, all the rules apply. The quotient rule, all rules are the same. Okay, all right. And in short, if you have y equal to e to the power of do. Now this u is a function of x. So example of u, probably x squared. All right. So how do you do the derivative? In short, y prime equals what? E to the power of u, e to the power of u, u prime. So in the book, they use dy dx equal to e u du dx. So it's not better, you know, shorter to write in terms of y prime equal to e to the power of u multiplied by u prime. So that is the rule, the formula for derivative of exponent function. Okay, all right. Now, examples. Example number one. Let's say I have y equal to e to the power of x. This is the simplest function. Okay, y equal to e to the function of x, then what? Then y prime is just equal to x. The same thing. Why? Because if I let u be equal to x, then what is u prime? U prime is just equal to 1. So therefore, the derivative is equal to what? The derivative is equal to e to the power of x multiplied by 1. But 1, you know, 1, you know, because it's trivial. So we just say e prime is just equal to ex. Okay, now second example. Let's say y is equal to e to the power of x plus 3. Now you don't have a simple x, you have x squared plus 3. So again, you let u be equal to x squared plus 3, then what is u prime? U prime is 2x. So therefore, the derivative is equal to e x squared plus 3 times 2x. So you can put the x at the beginning. Okay, all right. I'll give you another example. Let's say we have example 3, y equals to 5e for x. That is the square for x to the power of 3. Okay, for x to the power of 3. This is similar to the example in the book. So here you have a constant. And that constant will just follow the derivative. So again here, you let u be equal to 4x squared. And u prime is, no, cube here. U prime is 12x squared. So the derivative y equal to 5 e 4x cube multiplied by 12x squared. And of course, you can simplify a little bit. 5 times 6 is 5 times 12 is 16. Okay? All right. Okay, now I'll give you another example. Let's say I have y equal to 6x e to the power of 5x plus 21. Okay, how do we do that integral? Okay, here I have 6x. All right, and here I have e. So we apply product rule. So you got y equal to u b, and the product rule says u prime b plus b prime u. So we apply the product rule. So there are two terms, you know, 6x, and then the other term is in e. So we let u be equal to 6x, and then u prime is equal to 6. And then I let v be equal to 5x squared plus 21. What is v prime? V prime is 10x. So you put in the formula. So that will be equal to what? V prime is equal to u prime v. U prime is 6 multiplied by e. 5x squared plus 21 plus v prime u. V prime is equal to what? V prime is equal to, then you have to apply the derivative of the e. Okay? Derivative of the e. So, oh no, no, no. This is not right. Our v is not the power of e. Our v should be what? Our v should be the whole thing, e. Okay? So, that was not right. So the v is equal to e 5x squared plus 21. This is the right one. Okay, now what is v prime? So you remember v prime? Kena pakai ni lah. Okay, v prime you have to apply the rule. Okay, the rule of the exponent. Yeah. Okay, right. So what is it? But now v is the whole thing. So but remember, you still have to differentiate that power. Okay. So what is v prime? V prime, I think I don't have enough space over there. We should write it. So v prime is equal to e 5x squared plus 21. Now I have to differentiate the power, the power which is u prime. Now u prime is dv du lah. Or the dv. So that will be equal to what? That will be equal to 10x. Okay. So here, don't be confused with the u as v as per the product rule. Okay. This v here is the whole thing. So you can think of the v. Dv dx. Dv dx. So dv dx is e to the power of u. Okay, here u the power. And here you got du dx. Okay, all right. So that u sini ni, it's not the u as per the power rule. This u is the first term. Now this u is completely a different thing. This u is for the exponent. Okay, so when you do the derivative, you apply the derivative rule, and the power we call it u. But that u is good as far as the exponent term is concerned. So that's how you got an x. So u is equal to 5x squared plus 21, and u prime here, which is du dx, equal to 10x. So jangan confuse dengan u prime sini. Okay, our u prime here is for the whole function, the product rule for the whole function. This thing is only for the exponent term. Okay, for that second term, which is we call it v. So the v prime, that is that thing. So plus v prime, I have e 5x squared plus 21 times 10x. So that is v prime. Multiplied by what? Multiplied by u, which is 6x. So I got that derivative. Okay. All right. So that is the product rule. And then you can also use the quotient rule, okay? So quotient rule, you look at the example number 2, though. Then you look at example 2, then they use quotient rule. So the one you go home, that is the derivative of exponent function. Okay, for 12.2, okay, 12.2, I will give you some questions. Question from number 1 up to 18. Okay, you do some, don't do all. You do, you know, the power rule and then the product rule, some on the cost. All right? Okay. Good. So now, I want you to do question number, just one question. Okay, do question number 11. Okay, do number 11. I'll give you number 11. You have to apply that one. You know, you don't have to use the product rule, because it's only a constant multiplied by the exponent term. So do that number 11. Okay, the application, we do number 44. Oh, that is on the piece of value. And then you do one more thing, marginal cost, 47. And then pollution, 51. All right. So the 12.2 application 44. Okay, you got it. So for that question 11, how do you get the derivative? So it's just a constant 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by e to the power of, okay, what is the derivative of the u? You let u be the whole thing up there, x squared plus 1 to the power of 3. So what is the derivative of u? So you let u be equal to x squared plus 1, everything to the power of 3. Now what is u prime? So u prime is equal to 3, x squared plus 1, reduced the power by 1, and then you have to multiply by 2x. So that is the derivative of that u. Okay, so what is our u prime? The constant will just follow the derivative. So I have e to the power of u, multiplied by u prime. So you got 6x multiplied by x squared plus 1, everything squared. Okay, sometimes, you know, it's good to differentiate the different bracket. We put like that. So that you have because we have two brackets, okay? One is the inside, and then you have to close it with another bracket. So kita buat macam tu. All right, so you can simplify a little bit, but don't simplify more. Huh? So you just multiply 2 and 6, you got 12x, and then everything you keep them. Okay? All right. Now, if you look at application example 4. You look at example 4, that is on the future value. Okay, I want you to read that example for a few minutes and see what is it about. Then we can apply the rule. Yes? So the idea here, you are given the derivative. So again, you know, it's antiderivative. You are given the derivative, and then you want to find the function. So that is on future value. Okay, you have here, all right, the variables. What is the first variable is T. T means the time period. Now, what is the unit for the time period? Years, okay? So you know it's in years. And then S is the what? Is the future value, okay? S is the future value or the value. Called future value, as it future value in dollars. Okay, here in dollars. So you have S T. The future value is equal to 100 multiplied by e to certain power, and that power is the interest rate. Interest rate is 8%. So I have 100 ringgit, $100. Okay, initially. We have what? We have $100. Keep investing, okay? You keep investing. Interest rate is 8% annually. You don't withdraw any amount, okay? Everything that you get, the return, you will reinvest. So the interest will be compound, okay? Our interest will increase compoundingly. So you call it compound interest, okay? So you got the future value, we call it ST, equal to 100, which is the initial amount of investment, multiplied by E, and that 0.08 is our interest rate, multiplied by E, the number of years. Okay, now what do you want to find? You want to find the rate of growth of the money, okay? Rate of growth. So rate of growth is the derivative, okay? Rate of growth is S prime T. So derivative of S. So what is S prime T? So S prime T is equal to what? So you let U be equal to the bracket, to the terms, oh no, I'm sorry, the power. So U equal to 0.08. Now, what is U prime? U prime is 0.08. So you have 100 ringgit, $100, I'm sorry, 100, multiplied by E, 0.08 T, and then multiplied by U prime, so 0.08. So I have 100 multiplied by 0.08. So you can multiply that out. It's quite simple. So you got 8 E, 0.08 T. So that is the rate, the growth rate of our investment. Okay, S prime T. So the question says, what is the growth rate of money at the end of year one? So you substitute. So at T equal to one at n at the end of first year, S prime one, what is it equal to? 8 multiplied by E, 0.08 T. times 1. So you can get, so if you look at the book, the value is 8.66. And then you can find the growth of the money at year 10, okay, at the end of year 10. And then you can find any other year. So that is the rate of growth of money. So rate of growth at the time t equal to 1 is equal to, you can look at the book, and then at the end of year 10, so I can say at t equal to 10, you can also find the rate of growth of the investment that is equal to what? It's about 17.804. Now that is the rate of growth. If you want to find the future value of your investment, then you use ST, jangan pakai S prime. Okay? So here you will get S 10, S 10. So you can use the formula, not the formula, the original function. Okay? All right. Any question? Okay, saya bagi you, I give you a few questions so that will be sufficient. So that is the derivative. Okay, now we are going to look at the integral of exponent. So integral of exponent will be chapter 13 ke 14. Chapter number 14. Derivative is 11. Exponent, chapter number. No, not exponent. The integral chapter berapa? It's 12.5 differential equation. 12.6, 13. 15 point, bila kita nak cari memang susah. Kalau tak cari, jumpa. Okay. Chapter number. Chapter berapa? Cuba tengok buku. Chapter berapa? The integral. Integral. Chapter number. Integral of the eating. Chapter 11. Itu derivatif. Okay, 12.3. Okay, you go to 12.3. Just one section in the book. So look at 12.3. So 12.3, the exponent of, not exponent, the integral of the exponent. Chapter number, right? 12.3. Okay. Now you have the exponent. Okay, now exponent, the formula is this. If you have e to the power of u, that's derivative. So the concept is antiderivative. In other words, you have the terms on the right, e u multiplied by u prime, you integrate. What do I get? I get e to the power of u plus c. Okay, so tak payah, the second part tu tak payah ingat. Kita ingat yang ni je. So if I have eu, u prime, I integrate that, what do I get? I get eu plus c. So that is the formula for the integration of exponent. Okay, you got it? So that's the formula. Now let's look at a few examples. Okay, look at a few examples. We start with a simple example. Okay, this example here. Let's say you want to find, lagi senang. Tadi, di tu bagi yang tu. So, okay, kita tengok senang lagi. You look at the example number. Example number one. Itu yang paling kacang. Look at example number one. Okay, example one. So there is the integral. Integral of E. So that's section 12.3. Okay, now example one. What do we have? I want to find the integral of y equal to 5e to the power of x. Okay, what is the integral? Find the integral. Find the integral. Sometimes, no? Sometimes it's good that you put f of x. So find f. Integral is the capital F. So how do you do that? The integral of 5 ex dx. So you can put here f of x. Or you can capital Y. But if it's Y, then it's capital Y. So how do you do that integral? What is the formula? The formula says e to the power of u prime dx, then it equals what? E u plus c. So the constant here, don't worry, okay, that one will be just a constant follow the integral. So if I let u be equal to x, what is u prime? U prime just equal to 1. So there is 1 here. You don't have, no one, we don't write, but it's one over there, you know. If there is no, it's just equal to one. Ex times one is just ex, dx. So you have eu, u prime. So what is it? Just 5e of x plus c. So that is the integral. So this is the simplest formula. Okay? All right. Now, we look at a more complicated sikit, but not that complicated. All right, here. Here you have what? 2x e x squared. So you let u be equal to x squared. Then what is u prime? U prime to x. So therefore, I have eu u prime dx. So what is the integral? Integral is eu plus c, which is ex squared plus c. Okay, so that is quite straightforward. Okay, all right, I'll give you another example. Example number three. If we have y or f of x equal to five x squared e. Seven x cubed plus 11. Okay. Now, I want you to do this one. Okay, find the integral. See what you get. Okay, do it now. I'll give you 3 minutes to do that. Wih, tinggi sangat. Benda tu. Okay, got it. What is U? And then you have to find U prime. Okay, what is U prime? I 5x squared E 7x cubed plus 11. All right, everything. Okay, if I let U be equal to 7x cubed plus 11, now what is U prime? 21x squared. Okay, but I don't have 21. Okay, what we have, the terms you are given is 5x squared, which is not u prime. So how can you get u prime? What do you multiply that with? Constant of what? Ratio of what constant?
Is 5 over 21?
No, you cannot multiply by 5 over 21. Can we multiply by 5 over 21? You multiply by 5 over 21. This is half correct. Okay, half correct. Good. Thank you.
21 over 5.
You cannot also multiply by 21 over 5. Also cannot.
Should be the same.
4.2.
Because what we need to do here, you have to multiply by ratio, okay? Ratio of numbers, A over A, which is equal to 1. If you multiply by 5 over 21, or 21 over 5, this one look more logical. It's not equal to 1, so you cannot do that. You have to multiply by ratio of 1, of ratio of two numbers, that is equal to 1. Ratio of the same number, okay? Now, ratio of the same number, what did you say? 4.2. Why you choose 4.2? 4.2 at the decimal point. That is difficult. So, Sasuke, probably that is correct. Because if you multiply by 5, 4.2, you multiply by 5, 4.2 over 4.2. You multiply by 5, you dapat 21. 4.2 multiplied by 21. Multiplied by 5. 4.2 times 5. You get 21. Okay, you can multiply by 4.2. But we don't want decimal. We just want a whole number. What do you multiply that with? So this is half correct. Okay? Do you multiply by, if you look at this number, all right? Do you multiply by 5 over 5? Or do you multiply by 21 over 21? Either you cannot by 5 over 21 or 21 over 5. Okay? The ratio must be equal to 1. You remember that? Okay, ratio must be equal to 1. I give you some question. Homework. So, do you multiply by 5 over 5 or 21 over 21? Because what you want is u prime 21x squared. So, macam mana? You multiply by what number? By what ratio? 21. You multiply by 21, not 21. You multiply by what?
21 over 21.
You multiply by 21 over 21. Okay, 21 over 21, is it? Is it, what value do you get? You get equal to 1. 5 over 5 is also equal to 1. But you don't want 5, because you want 21. So, you multiply by 21 over 21. Right? Okay, is that clear? So, buat lagi soalan, okay? For those people who are still confused, do a question. So, what is it? You multiply by 21 over 21. So, what do we have? I have 5x squared. And then you rearrange. 7x cubed plus 11 multiplied by 21 over 21 dx. After that, you rearrange. Okay? Because you want your prime 21x squared. So now, I bring out 5 over 21. And then, you rearrange the things in that equation. So I got what? 21x squared. So here, this is EU. This one, U prime. So we can integrate. And of course, then we multiply with 5 over 21. So that will be equal to 5 over 21 E to the power of U. Okay? And then plus C, and you put that U, you put back the U. What is U? U is 7x cubed plus 11. So you finish it up. All right, U is 7x cubed plus 11. Sometimes you don't have to write E to the power of U. You can just write away, write E to the power of 7x cubed plus 11 plus C, because we know already the U is equal to 7x cubed plus 7x cubed plus 11. Okay. All right, any question about this? So always multiply by constant over constant, same value. Okay, so that ratio is equal to 1. Now you can multiply also with 4 over 2. Okay, okay lah. Tapi dia ada decimal point. All right, so we just one whole number. So what is the whole number? You multiply with the number, the ratio of the number, that is the coefficient of the U prime. Whatever it is, okay? Don't worry about that number 5. Don't worry about the number that you are given. Just multiply by the ratio of the constant, okay? That would be the in the U prime. Okay, all right. Any comment, any question? Okay, next. Look at example, the next one. For this part, we look at the example number 3. Okay, look at example number 3 on 12.3. Okay, 12.3, example 3. Example 12.3. Okay, on the 12.3, I'll give you some questions. You do some, okay, that's some of it. 12.3 from question 1 up to 16, okay, do some. Then application, just do a few of this. Okay, do number 43, that is on the revenue. And then 48, and then 49, the compound interest, and then I have value 52. Okay. So what do we get from that example? you have here, you are given. So exam, the application is more of antiderivative. You are given what? You are given the derivative. Okay, you are given the derivative. You want to find the function. So in other words, if you have y prime or dy dx, you want to find y. So you are given y prime or f prime of x or dy dx. So what you need to find is y equal to f of x. So you are given the derivative. So if you look at that example, you are given what? You are given the rate of change of the value of the house. So you are given the rate of change, dv dt. That is the derivative of the value of v. You want to find what is the value of the house. All right. In more detail, you will see here the V is the market value of the house. So in terms of V variables, V is the value of the property in what? What is the unit? Unit is in dollars. But if you look at the statement there, it's thousands of dollars. So thousands of dollars. All right. So in other words, if you are given 100, what does it mean? It means 100,000, okay? Because it's thousands of dollars. Or you know, if the value, if the number is 100, that means 100,000, because the unit is thousands of dollars. And then t, the independent variable is what? Is the time, okay? Time in years. So t is the time in what unit? Years. Since when? They don't give you the year 1, 2, 3. They give you the beginning time since 2015. So that is the beginning of time. So the beginning of time in this question, that is zero. So 2015, that is the beginning. Okay, so the T is zero. You don't put into the E to power of T, it's equal to E 2015. Salah, huh? Mana boleh? Okay, it's not the year, it's the number of years. So the time starting from 2015, so that is zero. Sometimes the year will start from where? From 1960. So that is T equal to zero. So it doesn't matter when the time started. For any time, any year, where is the it is the beginning. So the beginning is the zero, right? So here, 2015 is our zero. And then consequently, we can come up with any T for whatever year it is. So let's say you have 2000, the year 2000. Year 2000? Bukan 2000. 2000, tidak terbalik. So to 2020, okay? 2020 means what? 5 years lah. Yeah, all right. So that's how you work in terms of the time. So you want to find the value of the house. All right. So you want to find the value of the house in terms of T. So what is the value of the house? You want V. So what is V? V is the integral of dV dt. And that is equal to the integral of what? You have here the value of the dV dt is given by 15.4 E 0.077 T. Okay. Now, I want you to find what is the integral of this. Of course, everything is given now. Example can. Solution is already given in the book. But I don't want you to look at the solution. I want you to do it on your own first. Okay? And then compare with it. Do you get the same thing or you don't? So find the value of the house. Or in other words, find the integral. Okay, do it now. I give you 3 minutes. I want to give you the homework, the group homework before Kita terlupa. Okay, group homework. That would be 13.4. Okay, this is the group homework. Number two, okay, group number two. Now I want you to maintain the same group. Don't change your group. If one of your friends no more here, okay, whether you drop, she drop, or he drop, or withdraw, so you do on your own, okay? You don't have to find a new friend. So same group, and also the same person, submit. The same person who submit the first one, okay, same person who submitted the first one, the first one book, you will also submit the second one, so that I will have the same order, okay? So why you do this? Because I have the same order, so easier for me to make the grading, okay? So I have the same order. I don't have to reshuffle, you know, I have the same order of your names. So same group, same person, submit. Do you understand? Okay. Now, if you don't understand, ask me. Because I know there will be one or two people yang tak tahulah. Okay. Masih tanya faham, faham. Tapi bila buat, buat lain. All right. So make sure you understand this. Okay. I know there will be one or two people different person submitted. So I have a different order. So I want the same person submit. And of course, you discuss. Don't have only one person doing the question. Okay, you discuss. So homework group homework number two, 13.4, question number 7, and then question number 24. So those questions. And of course, you know, that is relevant to what we are doing. Okay, question number 24. They ask you only to find consumer supplies. They want only you to find consumer supplies. But find also the producer supplies. Okay, so get the producer supplies, consumer supplies. Okay, for that question number 24. Okay, you get both. All right, okay. Now we come back to that question. So here you have 0.077 T, which is the power of that E. Okay. 15.4 is just a constant, so don't worry about that. Okay. Now, what is U prime? What is U prime? You let U be equal to 0.077 T. Okay. Now, what is U prime? 0.077. Okay. So what do you do? What do you multiply the function with? So that we will get U prime, which is 0.077. Multiply by what? Ratio of what number?
0.077 over 0.077.
Okay, good. you multiply by that. All right, so you multiply by ratio of 0.077 divided by 0.77, because that is the coefficient. Okay, so what you get now is you bring the 5 outside, 5.4, you bring it out, and then you have the E term, and then you multiply by 0.077 divided by 0.077 dt. Okay, don't forget that dt.
Sir,
yes.
Say
15.4. 15.4, yeah, 15.4. Okay, thank you. So rearrange, okay? So you got now 15.4. You bring the denominator 0.07 out. Then we have the integral, or not the integral, yeah, the integral of the exponent 0.077 t 0.077 dt. So now I have here is eu, and that thing here is u prime. So what is the integral? The integral is simply 15.4 divided by 0.077. That is equal to, if you look at the value, that would be equal to 200, right? 200, and then you got E, 0.077 T plus C. So that is our integral. Okay, so now what you want to find next is that what is the value in 2025? So I want to find the value in 2025. So 2025, senior, okay, 2025 from 2015, 10 years. So I want to find the value of the house at T equal to 10, okay? So you want to find the value of the house at T equal to 10, 10 years, 2025. Okay, so that is part B. But before that, you need to find that C. Okay, so in order to find the C, you are given one piece of information. You are given one point. What is the point? The point is, or the information given is what? The value of the house is 200,000 in 2015. So that we enable us to get C. So to find C, all right, you are given what? You are given the value equal to 200, because 200,000, the units here is 200,000. The unit is in thousands of dollars. So V is 200, okay, 200,000, 200. When what? When T equals what? 2015. 2015 to zero. Okay? So initially at T equal to zero, the value of the house is $200,000. So 200 lah. All right? So substitute. Substitute into V. Okay? Okay. So I can put here that is V. So only V. All right? Okay. So you have 200,000, I'm sorry, 200, multiplied by 0.077t plus c. You substitute that one point, we can get c. Okay, all right. So what is the value of c? The value of c is zero. So you have here, by substitution, you got 200 equal to 200e. To the power of 0.077 times 0 plus e. E to the power of 0, e to the power of 0 is 1. All right, so t to the power of 0 only 1. So what is c? C is equal to 0. Okay, c equals 0. 200 minus 200 is 0. So therefore, our value of the house is equal to 200 e 0.077. T. So that is our value of the house. Here, You know, after you got find, you have to, after you found the C, you can answer part B. Okay, so part B substitute, substitute T equal to 10. So you substitute T equal to 10 into here. Then you get the value of the house at 10 years or after 10 years. Okay, all right, so good. So I give you some questions that would be enough for your practice. Okay, all right. So that's it. Okay, that's it for the exponent. So now we move on to our last topic. Anything that I missed, okay? Anything that I missed, we have 3 more weeks, okay? 3 more weeks of classes. So 3 more weeks, anything I missed that I need to cover, I will cover later. So I will keep, you know, I will keep in touch of the things that I need to cover that I missed. I will cover within the next few weeks, 3 weeks. Right. So now we move to matrices. Now matrices is chapter number book. That is chapter number 4. Eh, bukannya. For the inequality. Chapter number 3. So matrices chapter 3. We are going to look at the basic idea of matrices, matrix. So I will show you some pictures. Okay. So we are on matrices. We want to find, or you want to define what is a matrix. Okay, what is a matrix? A matrix is simply what? It's simply array of numbers, you know? And these numbers are arranged by the position in terms of the number of rows and the number of columns. So it's just like a box, all right? So sometimes people say a matrix is a rectangular array of numbers arranged in terms of what? In terms of rows and columns. So you see here, they are arranged in rectangular, it's like a box, a rectangular shape. And elements or the numbers are described by the position, okay, in terms of rows and columns. Now, what is a row? A row is the one that goes from left to right. Horizontal, okay, horizontal is the row. So here I got row number 1, row number 2, row number 3, that's rows. And then columns goes from top to bottom, vertical. So column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, okay? And the elements or the numbers are positioned in the respective rows and columns. Right, so if I can just draw it, you know, if something like this, here I got rows, okay, row 1, here row 2, here you can say row 3, and then I have a column, I don't know, so I column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. So the elements or the numbers are arranged, okay, or in position in the respective rows and columns. So for example, if you look at that, we can put a number here, say 2, here 4, 0, 1, 5, 6, 0, 10, 10, 0. Okay, negative 2, 3, 7, 8. So these are the elements or the numbers. how the opposition in location in terms of the respective row and respective column. So if you look at the number two, okay, the first element there. Now that element, where is it located? It's located two, ni, located where? Row one or first row, what is the column? Column one. So that is the element in row number one, column number one. And that is denoted by, we'll come back to that. And then you look at number 10. If you look at the number 10 here, okay, how do you describe that 10 in terms of position in the matrix? It is what, number 10 or the element 10 is located where? It's located at, or the element at row number two. So 10 here is row number two. What is the column? Column three. So that would be the value. So you describe an element in terms of its position in the respective row and column. That's how you define an element in terms of their position. Now, in general, okay, in general, we have matrix of M by N, right? So you have M row and N columns. So in general, you have M by N matrix. So in general, I come back here, you have a matrix A, dimension is M by N. Now, this is the number of rows, that is the number of columns. So we call it AM by N. You don't multiply it, okay? So you don't say A2 by 3, that is equal to A6. You don't multiply. Let's call it 2 by 3, all right? So that is not true. So A2 by 3 or, you know, M by N. So the first number is the number of rows, and then the second number is the number of columns. So the example that I have here, three rows and four columns, this is 3 by 4. So M here is 3 by 4, three rows, four columns. Now in general, you have M row. So the number of rows is M, denoted by I, can call it I, one up to what, M. And then the number of columns, what is it? N. So we call J from 1 up to N. Okay? So in general, you have what? You have N, M row. So row 1, row 2, all the way up to row M. And then similarly for the column, column 1, column 2, C1, C2, all the way up to column N, CN. Okay, so you have M by N. So this matrix, call it A, is M by N. So that is a general form of a matrix. Okay, and the element in general, you call it A. So A11, what does it mean? A11 means what? A11 means the element in row one, column one. So the first number is the row, the number of the row. The second number, column. So A11 means what? Row one, column one. Element row one, column one. Okay, and then if you have A23, what does it mean? It means the element, row number two, column number three, up to AMN, element row M, column N. Okay, so that is the general form of a matrix. That M by N is any number. So that is the general form of a matrix. Okay, any question? So that's how you define a matrix. So for example, we have here, uh, C, okay, a matrix. Matrix here is what? Two rows, three columns. So it's 2 by 3. And the matrix D is 3 rows, 2 columns. So 3 by 2. So that is the size of the matrix. All right, the row by the column and by any, what is it? The size or dimension. Okay, size, sometimes they call dimension of the matrix. What is the other term they call? Benda tu panggil? Same order. Okay? Same order tu lain lah. Same order tu, yeah, same order is the size. Okay, same order means you have the same row, you have the same number of columns. Okay, all right. So that is the basic definition of the basic concept of matrix. Okay, now there are special, a few types of special matrix. Number one, we call it square matrix. Square matrix is where we have what? Where you have the number of rows equal number of columns. So example here is 3 by 3. 3 rows, 3 columns, 3 by 3, square. Okay, or you can have 4 by 4, 5 by 5, whatever. 30 by 30, so that is a square matrix. Now, if matrix is consisting of only one row, don't worry about the number of columns. We call it row matrix. Okay, so example here, 9, 5. 2 columns, 1 row. Here, 3, 2, 1, 6. 1 row, 4 columns. Row matrix, okay, 1 row. And if it is consisting of one column, what do you call it? You call it a column matrix, regardless of how many rows are there. Okay, all right. So that is row and column matrix, and also column vectors. Now zero matrix. Zero matrix is the matrix that consists of what? All the elements are zero. So here is the zero matrix, zero matrix, zero matrix. So zero matrix, macam zero, the number zero, correct? Okay, what else? This is the transpose of a matrix. Okay, what is the transpose of a matrix? When the rows and columns are changed, that would be what? That would be the transpose of. So let me just, so I get A, okay? A equal to 1, 0, 2, 1, negative 3, 4. So this is 3 by 2, all right? Now, transpose of A is what? It's equal to what? 1, 0, 2, 1, negative 3, 4. So that will be what? 2 by 3. So transpose of a matrix, the rows becomes column, right? So row number 1 will become column 1. Row 2 becomes column 2, and so on. So I have a row number 1, that becomes column number 1, right? Row number 2 becomes column 2. Row number 3 becomes column 3, okay? So that is transpose of a matrix. Okay, all right, good. So I will stop here because we have Azan already. So Azan now is just on the dot. So we'll stop the class and I will see you again Wednesday. So, hey, homework day. Did I give you the deadline of the homework, the due date?
No, yes, sir.
Not yet, kan? Saya bagi question dia. Saya belum bagi lagi. I forgot. So you should ask me, when is the due date? Saya lupa already, mana dia? So that thing is, the due date is, where did I put that thing? Tak apalah, I write the due date here. Okay, the homework, due date. You can submit you submit before, okay, not after. This is the letters, okay, that's the letters. Sunday, 5 p.m. This Sunday, if I'm not mistaken, 16th of January, 5 p.m., 16th January 22. Okay, so remember that bit. So make sure you prepare early, you know. Don't copy. I know some people copy the homework because they just give me a perfect homework, less step, suddenly boom, answer. So if don't give me a 10-minute homework, okay? Give me a proper homework. So I will see a good homework. So I'll see you again. Have a nice time studying. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.